Deep down, you know you weren't built for fighting, but that doesn't mean you're not prepared to try. What they don't know is your real advantage. When you live for someone, you're prepared to die.
Deep down, I know that I'm just a human.
True,
but you I know that I can draw my sword and fight. With my short existence,
good,
I can make a difference.
Yes, excellent.
I can be there for him. I can be his knight. I can do it for him. You do it for her.
Tell me a little more about your family.
They're pretty normal, I guess. I'm not like any of them, but that doesn't really bother me.
Never?
Only when they say things like, Alex, you study too much, or don't freak out, or go do something fun.
So your siblings, they don't experience the same pressures you do?
Oh God, no. They don't care about school.
Why do you think that is? I mean, you all grew up in the same house with the same parents, yet you're the only one who feels this enormous pressure to achieve at such a high level.
Why do we even have to talk about my family? They don't have anything to do with this. They don't get me.
How's that feel?
I don't know.
Smart girl. Try a little harder.
I said, I don't know. I feel kind of alone.
You never accept help from anyone, ever, because you're too proud. I wanted to do a nice thing.
I don't need nice things.
Oh, because you're so above it all and strong.
Now his life is over, and I can't help but feel responsible for that. He tried to save me. No, he didn't.
Because we couldn't.
I couldn't. In 10 years' time, I want to live in a house with big windows. I want the house to be large enough to have a kitchen table with 4 chairs, but not too roomy so I can feel the depth of my aloneness.
Missy Cooper, you apologize to your brother Rhett this second.
No.
I am not going to tell you again.
Why do you always take his side?
I do not.
Yes, you do. Everybody does. I hate this family.
My dad is football, older brother. So they're like a team. And my mom and meatball spent all their time fussing over children. So they're like a team, too.
It's never done that to you.
Nope.
Yeah, when I woke up this morning, that's where I found it.
Right after you got yours?
Thank you!
Oh my god, welcome to my world! Last week, I got this beautiful plaque from the 18th for Outstanding Achievement. And what did my mom do? She found one of Luke's participant ribbons and a certificate Haley got for showing up somewhere on time and put all three of them together on the same shelf! It's like so unfair!
Why do you keep yelling at me?
Because everyone always lets me down!
It's my job to take care of this family.
Sometimes it's this family's job to take care of you.
Person who has raised herself from a very young age. And from what I can tell, you're doing a very good job. But sometimes when we haven't been parented securely, we can suffer from low self-esteem. Now you've taken quite a knock, and that kind of rejection can feel very painful. I would say that you were good enough to get into that course in the first place. I reckon that you are just as worthy of succeeding as anybody else there.
Now it's clear to me. You didn't blow out the candle, a little boy. You never learn. You don't play with fire, but you already burned. You already burned.
Still
I'm sorry, man.
You could have at least looked me in the eye when you ripped out my heart.
I didn't mean to.
You didn't mean to?
You didn't leave behind anyone you cared about? Well, I did have a girlfriend. May.
You're protecting yourself.
No, I'm trying to put myself in your shoes.
You'll never be in my shoes. And you'll never know how unfair that is.
I try to be tough, but I want to scream. How could anybody do the things you did so easily? And I say I don't care. I say that I'm fine. But you know I can't let it go. I've tried for so long.
13 months, you'll be a P2, and a cop will treat you like one of the guys, but I'll have to prove myself to every cop I work with.
And Barbie is on a plastic doll with big boobies. When did
it end? It is literally impossible to be a woman.
If you could use makeup or your phone one last time, which one would you pick? Makeup or your phone?
Is this what you think
time?
Girls have trouble choosing?
Yeah. Can you really go anywhere without your cell phone?
Yes.
How long?
You're going to walk home with more than maybe just a trophy tonight. I think lots of men.
I'm not going to walk home with any men tonight.
Big difference between the Golden Globes and the NFL. On the Golden Globes, we have fewer camera shots of Taylor Swift. I swear.
Because nobody takes girls seriously in this field. They just don't.
Give us a smile, Blondie.
Why are these men looking at me?
Yeah, they're also staring at me.
Ladies! Yoo-hoo.
Oh, you got fries with that?
If I said you had a hot body, would you hold it against me?
Is that a mirror in your pocket?
Maybe you are.
He's just not.
And tell me how you hate me, still trying to replace me, chase me, chase me. Tell me how you hate me, erase me, erase me. Wish you never dated me. Lies, tell me lies, baby, tell me how you hate me.
Besides, Luke already is the best at something. Being my son. Honey, I'll talk to your dad.
You don't think he'll be upset that I wrote it about you?
You wrote it about me?
Mom, you know me and homework. I didn't give it much thought. What's a hero? someone who's not afraid of anything and who's strong, that's you.
Hey, Mom. I brought you some soda, but I couldn't find any straws, so you'll have to drink it like cats.
Oh, thank you, Luke.
My sweetie.
I was just upset when I thought it was Luke.
Haley, honey, I really wish you'd give me a hand with all this laundry. You would never, ever.
Haley's off in her own world. Alex has never really been a kid. But Luke is my baby. Is it really too much to ask that he stay a sweet, innocent kid? Forever?
Yes, I did, because I wanted to spend some time with my son. You've been pushing me away so much lately, and I don't want you to grow up to be the kind of kid who doesn't care if his mom shows up at his wedding.
What are you talking about?
Nana isn't coming today, and Mitchell's moved.
Oh, I'd be really sad if you missed my wedding.
Really? You promise?
Totally.
Still love you.
With the same pains as me, having done this time and time again, she wore a yellow cardigan. I just wanna stop the scars that grow every time that I go home. That's why I came up here instead. That's what the girl in the cardigan said.
It's just anatomy, you're only half of me. Still you don't know me at all. You know how much I hate that everybody
showing you too many pictures of me with my friends. Okay, I can stop doing that too. Now I'm actually a calculated manipulator rather than a smart businesswoman? Okay, I'll disappear from public view for years.
He made me think there were no rules, but I was wrong. There are no rules if you're a boy.
Feminists are seen as mad women who believe that female is the only true gender and spit on any man who tries to open a door for them.
I don't know how.
is literally impossible to be a woman. You are so beautiful and so smart, and it kills me that you don't think you're good enough. Like, we have to always be extraordinary, but somehow we're always doing it wrong. Like, you have to be thin, but not too thin. And you can never say you want to be thin. You have to say you want to be healthy, but also you have to be thin.
Vocabulary for men and women in the music industry, right?
Give me an example.
Okay, a man does something, it's strategic. A woman does the same thing, it's calculated. A man is allowed to react. A woman can only overreact.
These aren't actually my clothes. I borrowed them because I wanted you to take us seriously. Because nobody takes girls seriously in this field. They just don't.
It means equality, and no one would object equality. No one should object equality. And it just means that women should have equal rights as men. And then I said, well, it's very simple. It's not as complicated as some people have made.
I'm just so tired of watching myself and every single other woman tie herself into knots so that people will like us.
But don't tell me that crybaby Petey McHugh wouldn't have gotten an audience with Victor in a matter of moments if he'd asked politely, because you and I both know that he would.
I'm not a poet. I'm just a woman. And as a woman, there's no way for me to make my own money. Not enough to earn a living or to support my family. And if I had my own money, which I don't, that money would belong to my husband the moment we got married. And if we had children, they would be his, not mine. They would be his property. So don't sit there and tell me that marriage isn't an economic proposition, because it is. It may not be for you, but it most certainly is for me.
I'm not good enough for anything.
It is literally impossible to be a woman. You are so beautiful and so smart, and it kills me that you don't think you're good enough. All the enjoy.